All right, let's now head over to San Francisco for the latest at the Philippine consulate over there. Romel Conclara joins us for the update there. Romel, what can you tell us so far what's happening there in San Francisco?
DJ, like you said, I'm right here in the Philippine consulate in San Francisco on the fifth floor, where behind me, well, unfortunately, you can't see because of they got the canvassing board, but they are finalizing all election votes. Looks like they're about halfway done. They have 24 precincts. Last time I was told that they're at they went through 12. So we should be wrapping up pretty soon. Here at the Philippine Consulate in San Francisco, they have a jurisdiction that spans over 10 states in the United States, and have the record, the biggest number of voters. That's 47,711 registered voters. According to the consulate staff I spoke with this morning, they said that they had a record turnout. We'll get that number to you as soon as possible, but it's definitely bigger than the last two previous elections. Now, I was here this morning at 3 a.m. Again, that final call time to get those votes in was at 4 a.m. I did find a Phil-Am couple who made it in just in time at 3:45 a.m. The reason why they came in a little late, but just on time, is because they had a little mix up with their address, but they were able to figure it out with the consulate and cast their two ballots. And now, since they were up, they're here along with other poll watchers, really waiting to see what the final account's going to be. TJ?
Well, spared. I mean, I think because, of course, I live with you in the Bay Area. We were spared from the delays that were affecting Washington, D.C., York, you know. So given that, you know, Conjen Ferrer had always promised us that he was confident about the voter turnout. What's the vibe you're getting from them? They may have not given you the numbers just yet, but what's the vibe you're getting from the consulate in terms of the participation of the voters, in terms of how early people are mailing back their ballots, how people are actually physically coming in and putting in the ballots in those the drop boxes?
Right. Well, TJ, yeah, like you said, we've been here, we're on the ground, we're hearing from people on many sides supporting each candidate. They were very adamant in not just getting their packet and turning it in, but a lot of them from all over the Bay Area who are here in driving distance wanted to come to the consulate, physically turn the ballot in. Just like that Phil-Am couple I was talking to this morning, they said they trust the process, they believe in the integrity of the election, but they personally wanted to get that ballot in there. Rallies from all different candidates were especially motivated to turn out and make sure they're both counted.
And I know you've been seeing and spending some time with the poll watchers there from different groups, different parties, different organizations. What's the sentiment that they're feeling right now with how the elections have turned out in the Philippines and even there, of course, in San Francisco, how they've been monitoring it, they've been observing it the last month there in San Francisco?
Well, TJ, the poll watchers, again, from both sides are showing up. They have been showing up for the last 3-4 weeks. They definitely take it seriously as they're setting up blocks and periods where they come in and relieve each other. So far, so good. They talked about like how everything has been a smooth process for the election process. There's not been a lot of any reports of anything out of the sort. And also with the consulate staff, that they believe that they've been working well hand in hand with them.
Well, good to hear everything running smoothly back there in San Francisco. We continue to get more updates from you on the ground as they start releasing the results there, when they start submitting their canvas results here to Washington, D.C. That's Romel Conclara reporting from San Francisco. Thanks, Romel.
The vote counting is not over yet, but former Senator Bongbong Marcos already expressed his thanks to those who supported him. He issued a video statement a short while ago. Here are portions of his message.